Hello everyone, good evening, how are you? Hello, hello, good evening everyone. How are you? How is your Tuesday going?
Good.
Hi Ava, good evening. Doris, hello, Vero, hello. Madeline, Elizabeth, ¿cómo están, chicas? Only
Hi, power.
So only Hi. Girls are super, super responsible.
Good evening.
¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo les ha ido? How are you, girls? Everything good?
Yes.
Hi, thank you. And you?
I'm okay. Everything's good. Everything's going super nice. Okay, y ya se va a terminar la semana. So that's even better. Okay. So thank you everybody for joining. Okay, so thank you for being in today's class. Today vamos a comenzar un tema nuevo. We are going to get started with a new topic. Okay. And just give me one second. Regáleme un minutito acá y les voy a compartir mi pantalla. I'm going to be sharing my screen. Fatima is coming also. Hi, Fatima. Hi. Okay. Okay, so everybody, ¿cómo sintieron la unidad número 2? Super fácil, right? Like super, super easy. That was a review, so it was not too complicated. Y espero definitivamente que esta sea like very easy as well. So let me share my screen. Okay, we are going to get started with session number 11, unit number 3. And today is October the 6th. Okay. So we are going to get started with some of the things that we are going to be working today. First, we have a little warm-up activity. Then we have present continuous practice. And then we have a little wrap-up. And we have some homework assignment que todos los días hacemos, al igual que la discussion, right? So let me just take a look at this one. Okay, give me just a quick second. Okay. Okay, everybody, so let's get started with the thing that we have for today. I have a little conversation for you guys. And this one, lo que vamos a trabajar ahora is describe future work events. So, I have a question for you guys. And this one says, who schedules the event at your workplace? What are some events that are taking place the next week? So we are in October and there are not too many events. But guys, ¿cuáles son las events de este mes en su compañía? Is there any event in October in your company? Do you have any celebration this month? Or in November or in December in the next month? Hay empresas que celebran el final de año, you know, some companies celebrate Christmas. Others, the end of the year. Other companies celebrate, I don't know, Halloween. So what about in your company? ¿Celebran algo? Do you celebrate anything? Elizabeth, what are you celebrating?
Realizamos la cena navideña, okay. pero como por la pandemia no sabemos si lo harán este año.
Elizabeth, ¿usted está trabajando ahorita desde la casa?
No, yo está yendo. Trabajo en la, fuera de casa, en una farmacia.
Ah, okay. But en la cena navideña se reunían en everything.
¿Manda?
Para la cena navideña se reunían en la en un lugar.
Sí, teacher. Sí, nos reservan la cena en un restaurante como el Trópico Inn,
okay.
O en la Castellana, en diferentes lugares.
Nice, okay, nice. So probablemente no la vayan a atender este año. I got that, all right. Yeah, right. Y esa es la nueva realidad probablemente para most of us. Quizás no haya party. And that's sad. But anyways. Okay. So here we have like some activities, okay, or some events that Peter and Henry are having these days. Okay. So I need two volunteers to help me read the conversation. Okay, so thank you very much. Let me see, Veronica. And thank you very much, Francisco. Hi, Francisco. So, Francisco, you can help me with Peter. And Vero, you can help me with Henry, please.
Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing to the company in the yearly conference? Henry?
Oh, it's Vero, but I think Vero left. Verito, hello.
Perdón, me tuve que levantar.
Ah, no, tranquila, no se preocupe. So, help me please reading Henry's part. You are talking to Francisco. Thank you.
Vero.
Hola. ¿Quién empieza?
Usted,
¿tú o yo?
Usted es Henry.
Ajá, pero empieza, no empieza.
You can start, Francisco, okay, you can start.
Hello, Henry. I have a question. Who is representing to the company in the yearly conference?
Hi, Peter. Well, Maria is, but Julie is attending the conference this year too, so...
I see, but if Julie is attending, who is delivering the presentation for the CEO next week?
With what? I am presenting with Hector, the new accountant.
So great. So I am informing the committee about it.
Excellent job, guys. Very nice pronunciation. Nice. Okay, good. So tell me, what activities are taking place very soon? ¿Qué es lo que esas personas van a hacer? What are they going to be doing? For example, what about Julie? What is Julie? La otra yo. What is Julie doing?
She is attending the conference.
Yes, she is attending the conference. Okay. And what about Henry? ¿Qué va a hacer Henry? What is Henry doing?
He's presenting.
Exactly. So he's presenting. And what about Peter? ¿Qué es lo que Peter va a hacer? What is Peter going to be
informing.
Doing?
Informing the committee.
Exactly. So he is informing. He says, I am informing. So we are talking about the future. No estamos hablando de ahora, but we are talking about future activities. Hello, guys. I see Sandra's. Sandra's already. Hello, good evening. Andres, hello. I see Gerson. Oh, my goodness. Gerson's camera.
Hello, everybody. Good evening.
Andres, good evening. Milagro, hello. Fatima, hello. I got Ada again, but hello.
Peter, good evening. I have a technical problem with the camera.
Eso veo, Gerson, que le parece like broken. But everything, is everything good or necesita asistencia?
No, I think that the camera in my computer doesn't turn on. That I leave the class and I sing in again.
Oh, please. Okay. Thank you. Si necesita ayuda, let me know. Okay. Así le solicito ayuda a los chicos de support. Okay. All right.
Come back.
Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. No worries. Thank you so much. Okay, everybody. So, les voy a tomar asistencia, like super quick. Me ayudan diciéndome present, please. Today is the 6th. All right. So, I got Fátima. Fátima
López. Present, teacher.
Thank you, Fátima. Ada Susana.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Miss. Guillermo. No. Todavía no. Christian, no yet. Isaac. Not yet, right? Luz.
Present, teacher.
Por acá. Hey, hello, Luz. Hello. Good evening. Elizabeth.
Present, teacher.
Nice, Elizabeth. Edith. Todavía no. Silvia. Is Silvia here? Not yet, right? Francisco.
Present.
Thank you, Francisco. Sandra, Patricia.
Present.
Thank you. And I got Francisco. Sandra, Beatriz, también, ¿verdad?
Present, teacher.
Nice. Gerson, está por ahí. Madeline.
Present.
Thank you, Madeline. Verónica.
Present.
Thank you, Vero. Doris.
Present, teacher.
Thank you so much. Milagro.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Miss. I got Jennifer. Not yet. Andres. Yes. Right.
Present, teacher.
Right there. Thank you. And Cesar. I'm missing Cesar. Okay. Thank you very much. And let me share my screen one more time. Oh, I see, let me see, Guillermo, right?
So, present.
Hi, Guillermo, give me one second. Solo lo marco acá. I'm gonna mark you here. De lo contrario, se me va a olvidar. Give me just a second. Let me mark Guillermo. Okay, everybody. So let me share my screen one more time. And so we are talking about future events here, sobre lo que ellos van a hacer. So one person is attending a conference, another person is presenting, and the other one is informing. So those are part of the activities they are going to be doing. Now, everybody, ¿cómo hablamos de planes a futuro? How do we describe future events, activities in the future? Like, for example, ¿qué voy a hacer mañana? What am I going to do tomorrow? I got some questions for you, and relacionados con la misma conversación, let's take a look. It says here, complete the following sentences and use the conversation above to help you. So, me ayudan. ¿Qué les falta? What is missing in sentence number one? He is... ¿Alguien se recuerda?
ING.
ING. Okay. So, he is presenting with the new employee. ING. Y la segunda, let's take a look. It was informing. So, this is the conversation. So, ¿qué le falta? What is missing in number two? I am informing. Exactly. I am informing. Very good. So, ¿Cómo hablamos de futuro? How do we talk about future events? How do we talk about future activities, future events? Okay, and similar activities here. So, vamos a usar present continuous for talking about these future activities. So, let me read it. Primero tenemos, we use present continuous to talk about arrangement. ¿Alguien recuerda el significado de arrange? What is the meaning of arrange?
Organizar.
Organizar, okay, yeah, exactly. So, organizar. So, arrangements for events at a time. So, esos son como citas, arreglos, okay. And so, ¿cómo lo vamos a usar? How are we going to use this? If you pay attention here, tenemos subject, verb be, and gerund. So, let me share. Les voy a compartir a document so we can work in a very easy way. Okay, so part of the structure here is the following. We have subject, we have verb be, we have a gerund, and we have a complement. But you may say, ¿qué es un gerund? What is this? A gerund va a ser un ing. So significa que es un verbo, pero en su forma de ing. Okay? So let me, well, give me just a second. Let me make this a little bit bigger. Okay, so vamos a comenzar haciendo lo siguiente. Okay, give me please or help me please con un par de verbos. Tell me some verbs. El primero que se le venga a la mente, Christian, tell me one.
Rain.
Rain, de llover.
Play.
Oh, play, thank you. Uh-huh. Play. And scissor.
Right.
Can you repeat?
Right, escribir.
Oh, okay, thank you. Yes. Another one.
Listen.
Listen, very good. Yes.
Drink.
Walk.
Drink.
Drive. Walk. Okay. Walk. Drink.
Run.
And run. Yes.
Eat.
Any other?
Right. Oh, right.
Eat.
Drive. The manejar, right? Drive. Drive. Yes.
Yes.
Clean.
Clean. Okay, very good. Now, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Primero, vamos a encontrar la forma ing de estos verbos. Significa que solamente les vamos a agregar ing, alright? I have played, for example.
Playing.
Entonces vengo y le voy a agregar ing. Ya lo hice. Playing. I got right. Pero este verbo de acá termina con e. Le voy a quitar la e, no la necesito. Writing. And I have writing. Mm-hmm. So, todos los que terminan con ellos se la voy a quitar. I don't need it. And I have writing. Listen. Solo le voy a agregar ing. And I got listening. Listening. Walk. Again.
Walk.
Ing. Walking. Drink. Le voy a agregar ing. Run. Oh, vamos a poner atención acá. Look. Run. Es bien cortito, super, super short. Y lleva una consonante, una vocal, una consonante. So, voy a duplicar la última y luego ing. So, running, like corriendo, running. Ajá. Drive. ¿Qué pasaba con las que terminan en e? ¿Se recuerdan?
También.
Le quita la e y se agrega ing.
Ay, se la voy a quitar porque no la necesito. And I'm gonna have driving. Ok, clean. Ese es cortito, sí, pero solo es un, son dos vocales, no es una. Entonces le agrego cleaning y ng. Y eso es todo. That's it. Super easy. Entonces recordemos un poquito de las reglas para agregarle ing. La primera, si lleva una e, como el caso de right, le quito la e, no la necesito. Ok. La siguiente, si es un verbo muy cortito, como en el caso de run. Ok. So. Si es consonante, vocal consonante, solo tres, por ejemplo, o súper cortito, le voy a agregar la misma letra, voy a agregar la misma letra y luego ing.
¿Okay? ¿Y el verbo comer, teacher?
El verbo comer. Ahora veamos, exacto. So, eat, we got it. Comer es súper cortito también. Pero tenemos consonante, vocal consonante.
No,
lo tenemos.
Vocal consonante.
No tenemos. Entonces, como no tenemos eso, yo no le puedo agregar una doble T. Entonces, solamente tengo eating. Exactly. So I got eating. Yes? ¿Estamos bien?
Teacher.
Yes, yes, yes.
En el caso de draw.
Dibujar.
D-R-I-W.
Dibujar.
Oh, draw, dibujar. En el caso de draw, no se puede porque...
Drawing.
Lo único que vamos a hacer con este draw, lo voy a agregar acá, y es tener drawing. No le puedo duplicar la W, ok. Porque la W es como una letra, es como una vocal adicional. Entonces, we cannot do it. Solo le agrego ing. So, ahora, guys, your turn. So, I'm going to write. Les voy a escribir un par de verbos para que me les agreguen ing. So, give me just a quick second because I don't see the full screen. Hold on. Okay, give me one quick second here. Okay, so we got it here. Okay, so let me write a couple of verbs for you, okay? And I need your help, okay, with the ing for it. ¿Cómo sería la forma ing? So we got, for example,
wake up.
So I have all these verbs and I need your help with the ing form. Solamente voy a agregarles un ejemplo here de este verbo try. No, let me go with study, es más fácil de ver. Okay. If you take a look at this verb, si vemos study, this one termina en Y, all right? But antes de la Y, before, hay una letra D. Okay, there is a D letter. Okay, acá veamos play. Play termina con Y también, pero antes de la Y hay una A. Entonces, ¿cuál es la diferencia? Cuando hay una vocal antes, solo le agrego ING. Pero cuando hay una consonante antes de la Y, actually, voy a hacer lo mismo. I'm going to do exactly the same. Entonces, eso es importante recordarlo porque no se hacen cambios, ¿ok? No vamos a hacer ningún cambio here. No le vamos a quitar, no le vamos a eliminar, ¿all right? So, in case you have a equation about this. So, everybody, tenemos like 3-4 minutes. Ayúdenme a completarlos como quedarían agregándole ing, agregándole la forma de gerundio, please. ¿Logran ver la pantalla o la hago más grande? Do you want me to make it bigger?
Sí, está bien. Okay.
Ah, okay. Okay.
Teacher, a question.
Andrés, tell me.
The in studying is igual que in playing.
Yes, yes.
Que no le, o sea, aunque sea vocal o consonante antes de la Y, siempre el ING.
Yes, that is correct. That is correct.
Okay.
Teacher, can you explain me, please, because And I know hear you that
yeah, sure, not a problem. It's okay, Gerson. Gerson todavía tiene dificultades con la cámara.
Yes,
¿no?
But I turn the other computer and I try to connect with
the other computer. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, sure. Let me go ahead. So, normalmente vamos a comenzar como un nuevo tema para hablar de futuro. Y esto se llama Present Continuous. So, esto me sirve para hablar de mañana, de mis planes, mis eventos en el futuro. 1 week, 1 month, 1 year. Okay? Como son como planes, okay, vamos a hacer un pequeño cambio. Here, vamos a usar esta estructura. Subject be ing, pero este ing es como un verbo, it's a verb, que al verbo le hemos agregado el ing, right? So, for example, si yo tengo play, lo único que voy a hacer es agregarle ing, right? A pesar que termina con e, yo no la necesito la e al final, so I eliminate it and I have ing. Listen, so listen, solo le agrego ing.
Okay. It's present continuous.
It's present continuous. Yes.
But I have a question because yes. Yesterday I did it the
¿Te hizo el ejercicio?
The homework 11.
Okay.
In the sentence, decía she is playing tomorrow. And I don't comprend because present continuous es como que está en el momento haciéndose.
No necesariamente, no necessarily. Present continuous puede ser usado como para ahorita, sí, tiene razón, you're right. Pero el uso que le estamos dando en esos momentos es para futuro, planes al futuro. So he is playing tomorrow, lo que usted está queriendo decir es casi asegurando que una persona va a jugar mañana porque ya es un plan el que tiene. So, por ejemplo, if I come y yo digo, hey guys, tomorrow, I'm gonna write my example here. If I say, for example, I am having an exam tomorrow, so yo estoy hablando de mañana, que mañana yo voy a tener un examen. I am having an exam tomorrow. Present continuous, pero hablamos de futuro. We're talking about the future.
Yes, ahí yo le preguntaba porque, digamos, sin querer, ¿verdad? Pensé que era la
tarea. Que correspondía.
Que me correspondía, pero no, y que era otro tema. Entonces, sí, me dejó un poco confuso porque sabía yo que era para acciones que se están haciendo en el momento, ¿verdad?
Eso es uno de los usos.
La otra pregunta es, ¿en el complemento debe de ir que es para mañana o después o no necesariamente?
Es lo más adecuado porque estamos hablando de futuro. Pero usted puede decir tomorrow, next Monday, next Tuesday. Pero si es necesario.
Sería presente continuo de que se está haciendo en el momento.
Exacto. Se puede confundir. Okay. So, para evitar confusión, it's better. Okay, everybody. So, ahorita lo vamos a ver. You're welcome, Harrison. So, let's take a look. So, wake, we said before que le íbamos a quitar la E. We don't need it and we have waking. Yeah, so waking. No cambia la pronunciación, solo le agregamos in. Waking. ¿Lo tienen así? Do you have it like this?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Get. ¿Alguien que me ayude con el spelling? Can you help me with the spelling, please?
Getting con doble T.
Getting.
Yeah, nice. Yes, double T, exactly. Double T, very good. Give. What about give?
Giving.
Like this?
Giving.
No.
The E.
No,
E. Yes. No, E. Exactly. Given. Excellent. Call. What about call?
Calling.
Calling. Excellent. Yes. Work. What about work?
Working.
Watch.
Watching.
Watching. Excellent. Try.
Crying.
Exactly, like trying hard. Okay. Ride.
Reading.
Don't need E. Writing, exactly. And send?
Sending.
Sending.
Sending, excellent, sending. So this is a gerund. Lo van a utilizar más adelante, like a lot. Pero esa es la idea del ing. Okay, so es de recordar un poquito de esas reglas de spelling. And now, the problem or the... ¿Puedo borrar? Can I erase?
No, teacher, no. Oh.
Yes.
No, no, teacher.
So if you want, you can take a picture, you can take a screenshot.
Oh, sí. Oh, yeah.
Okay, thank you. So, the idea... Well, lo voy a dejar ahí abajo, just in case. I'm going to put it all the way down. Okay. Now, the point is... What are you doing
tomorrow?
So imagine, guys, that we are talking about tomorrow. What are some activities that you are doing tomorrow? And we gotta write or we gotta mention some of these activities to your classmates. Okay, so what are you doing tomorrow? So, vamos a seguir esta estructura para que sea más fácil, okay? Tomorrow, I am, okay, so, sigamos esto, I, y luego necesito el verbo be, okay? Pero no puedo decir I be, I, this is not possible, sino que lo conjugo, I am, y ahora tengo el ing. So, what are you doing tomorrow? Tomorrow es miércoles, me toca, for example, ¿qué me toca? Me toca barrer. All right. I am de la limpieza. Y tengo clean. Pero esta combinación no se puede. We already know que yo no puedo decir I am work, I am clean. So le voy a agregar el ing. Y eso es super good. Tomorrow, I am cleaning my house. Tomorrow. And that's it. So así expreso some of the activities that I'm doing. Okay, for example, imagine that I am a doctor like Ada, and I say, oh, mañana tengo una cirugía. Okay, so I am, tengo, pero no puedo decir I am have. This is not possible. No puedo tener am y luego have. Entonces, I am having a surgery tomorrow. Tomorrow at 7 a.m., let's say. So I am having a surgery tomorrow at 7 a.m. Okay? So estoy hablando de mañana. I'm talking about tomorrow.
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes, Milagro.
El ing expresa pasado con los verbos que dicen endo.
No, miss. En este caso, cuando usted dice I am having, esto significa we are talking about the future. This is future. Es como que usted diga yo voy a. Okay, como casi segura que usted va a hacer eso. Cuando usted dice, I am cleaning my house tomorrow, usted está diciendo, yo voy a limpiar mi casa mañana. If you say, I am having a surgery tomorrow, usted está diciendo, voy a tener una cirugía mañana. O voy a hacer una cirugía mañana, all right? For example, guys, what are you doing tomorrow? ¿Qué van a hacer mañana? What are some of your plans? Imagine, for example, yes?
I am meeting at the 7 a.m.
Okay, very nice. So I am having a meeting. Voy a tener una reunión. I am having a meeting at 7 a.m. And even, como puede confundirse, puedo decir tomorrow. I'm having a meeting at 7 a.m. tomorrow. O le damos vuelta. I am having a meeting tomorrow. At 7 a.m., que sería el orden como más común en el que encontramos la hora. So, we are being super, super specific. So, ¿qué van a hacer mañana? What are you doing tomorrow? What are your plans for tomorrow? So, remember que vamos a agregar a ing right here. So, I'll give you like a couple of minutes, guys. On your notebook, intentemos escribir algunas de las actividades that you are doing tomorrow. What are you doing? I am having a meeting. I'm cleaning my house. I'm having a surgery. Voy a pagar mis recibos. I am paying some bills. Okay. Voy a ir por comida. I am going to the grocery to buy beans and food. Okay, so this represents tomorrow.
Teacher, I have a question. The bear prepare, o sea, preparar. ¿Cómo se conjuga? ¿Cómo sería?
Dani, ¿verdad?
Prepare.
Yes.
Okay. So, solamente recordémonos que el prepare, la letra E, no la necesito. Entonces,
preparing.
I am preparing some documents or a balance, for example. I'm preparing a balance for tomorrow. Aunque en vez de preparing, hay otros verbos que pueden funcionar bastante bien. Por ejemplo, I am working, estoy trabajando en vez de preparar. Por ejemplo, si usted está preparando un balance,
yo no tenía
usted
puede verde, decir, pero
I am working on a balance. I am working on a report. En vez de preparing, podría funcionar también to work.
Okay. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Teacher, una
yes. Teacher, okay. No problem.
Yes. Creo que fue Luz, right?
No. Yo.
Avilén.
Oh, sí. Avilén, tell me. La confundí la voz de repente con la voz de Luz. Tell me, Avilén.
Bueno, la consulta era, dicen que, por ejemplo, shopping, que compra, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Pero eso ya lleva la ING, ese no cambia si lo pongo en la oración, no hay
lo
problema.
Lo que sucede, Miss, es que shopping no es un verbo, sino es como las compras. Entonces, le recomendaría to say, I am going, voy a ir de compras. I am going shopping. Next week. Se escucha como un poquito raro que ambas tengan ING, but this is the best combination.
Okay.
Como voy a ir de compras.
Ya comprendí. Gracias,
teacher. Welcome. Yes.
Teacher, ¿y review? ¿Como de revisar?
I am reviewing.
Reviewing.
Yeah.
Y W siempre.
Yes, but only one. Review, remember that le duplicamos solo los verbos super cortitos. This is not the case, so I'm reviewing. Okay. But again, instead of review, you can say check. I am checking.
Checking.
Yes,
okay.
I am checking. For example, si voy a revisar algo, like in our case, I'm checking, yeah. O si le está asignando nota, you can say grading. I am grading.
O como, assignment. O assignment. Tarea.
I am grading assignments.
Assignments.
Yes, you can say this. I'm grading. So es como le estoy dando nota. Or I'm checking assignments.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Teacher, I have a question. Other question. Sorry.
Yes.
The difference they use that. The present continuous future, con going to y con will.
You will study that topic later, like in level number 5. Because
I know, but the difference, ¿cuál sería la diferencia, digamos?
What happens, Harrison, is that no los quisiera confundir. So.
Okay.
So that's why. But but just FYI, like for your information, la diferencia está en el uso. Will es más una predicción. This topic es un arrangement. Es algo que ya está organizado. So, es como en seguridad, like, ¿qué tan seguro está que lo va a hacer? That is the one. Don't be sorry. Your question is super valid, super good. But, yeah, no quiero meterme como en muchos detalles because I can confuse you. That's why.
Teacher.
Francisco, tell me.
¿Qué palabra podría ocupar para decir, por ejemplo, nosotros decimos cuadrar?
I have to make ends meet. So you can use this one. Se lo escribo en el chat. I'm going to write it in the chat.
Please.
That's the word. Okay, everybody. So do you have some of your activities? Did you finish? Are you ready? Do you have some events? Do you need more time? 1 minute? 2 minutes? 3 minutes? 1 minute. Okay, it's fine.
Teacher.
Yes, ma'am.
Y en una oración podemos, no se puede especificar el día, porque solo veo que ponemos tomorrow, tonight.
Yes, of course, you can be super specific. Give me your example. Tell me, what is your example, miss?
Por ejemplo, yo tengo uno que dice, I am going shopping in the supermarket on Sunday.
Oh, hold on, hold on, hold on. Give me 1 second. I am going shopping
in the supermarket on Sunday.
I'm going shopping in the supermarket. Supermarket on? On Sunday, you said, Sunday. Right? Okay, on Sunday. Yes, this is very good, but because this is for the future, en vez de decir on, instead of saying on, I would recommend you to use next to be even more specific. Next. But the rest, super, super nice, yes.
Gracias.
Welcome.
Teacher.
Milagro, tell me.
Y en estas, bueno, solo he hecho 2 oraciones, pero necesito que me corrija.
Sure, tell me.
I am calling to my parents in the morning.
Okay, let me erase some here. Give me 1 second. I am calling my parents. Next.
No, yo no le puse next, solo le puse I am calling to my parents in the morning.
I'm calling to my parents in the morning. Yeah, that's okay. That's a good one. Yes, Milagro? You got it.
Y puse I am sending email the Monday.
Como es futuro, podríamos utilizar next. Como el próximo lunes. I'm sending emails next Monday. Okay. They are good. They are very nice.
Teacher.
Yes, Francisco.
La palabra que me dio significa llegar a fin de mes.
No. No. No, es como hacer eso, como que todo cuadre. Ajá.
Ah, ok.
Okay, everybody, so 1 more minute.
Teacher, a question.
Andres, tell me.
I write the sentence, I am cooking dinner in the night.
Hi, very good. Really? Is this for real?
Dinner? In the night. The night. That's my question.
This is good.
Como I'm cooking dinner at night. Is in or at?
Yeah, remember, in is para la mañana, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening. Si es en la night, at night. Yes, exactly.
Thanks.
Okay, you're welcome. Andres, is this real? Are you cooking dinner? Or only 1 example?
Yeah. No, real. I am cooking.
Oh, you're cooking today.
I am cooking my dinner.
Oh, your dinner. Okay. Oh, you can be more specific here. I'm cooking my dinner. Okay, very nice. That's okay.
I love cooking.
Oh, nice. Here. Oh, that sounds very good. Okay. Okay, everybody. So, Is everybody ready? Are you ready, people? Everything good?
Yes.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay, very good. Now let's go and join some groups so you can tell your classmates qué es lo que van a hacer. What are the activities you are going to be doing? I'm going to give you some time. Listen to your classmates. Listen carefully to them. Practice with them, everybody. And you have only 5 minutes. Share. ¿Qué es lo que van a hacer? What are you doing? What are you doing tomorrow? What are you doing on Monday? What are you doing next week? So let's join and let's get going. Let's go, guys.
¿Cuál es la actividad?
Solo les tiene que comentar lo que usted va a hacer, Milagro. What are the activities that you are doing? De los mismos ejemplos, the same examples que acaba de escribir, the same examples you wrote.
And you, Veronica?
I am tomorrow.
What are you doing tomorrow?
Vamos a tener que contestar. I am going tomorrow. Cooking.
All right. Berito, son los mismos ejemplos, lo que usted acaba de escribir. Like, I am cooking tomorrow. I am going to the church. I am going to the beach. Es lo mismo que usted acaba de escribir. Like, what are you doing tomorrow?
Sandra, Patricia, what are you doing tomorrow?
Hi, Madeline. I am chicken. Chicken.
Okay. We got that.
Perito, sí. Que no veo ya del sueño.
Oh, yeah. I imagine so. No worries. Perito, si necesita ayuda, me lo puede escribir. You can text me.
Okay. Ajá, es que me perdí. Entonces, no se por eso no.
Escríbanme, okay. Send them to me. I can check them.
Okay. I am checking a segment tomorrow at 8 a.m. I am replying to message. I am meeting my teacher tomorrow at 7 a.m.
Okay, nice. Or another teacher.
Yes.
Okay.
What are you doing tomorrow, Fatima?
I am writing a report tomorrow. I am cooking my breakfast tomorrow in the morning.
Pregúntele a otro, Fatima.
Okay. What are you doing tomorrow, Andres?
Too busy.
Very good. Because you said going.
To where? Going. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes. Going to visit. Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Doris.
Mi segunda. I am calling to my best friend in USA.
Repeat.
I am calling to my best friend in USA.
In USA.
Okay, I have. I am cooking a diner where at my parents.
Repeat, please.
I am cooking a diner where at my parents. It's correctly, teacher.
Can you listen to me now?
Yes.
Okay. Can you repeat, Cesar? What was your sentence?
Okay. I am cooking a diner where at my parents.
Yeah, I think it's good. I think I got it. Solo que tomo le where. So I'm cooking a dinner at my parents. Y podemos agregarle como en la casa de mis papás, ¿verdad?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So podemos agregar como my parents' house. I'm cooking dinner at my parents' house. Uh-huh. Okay. Lo demás, super nice, yes.
Okay, thanks.
Welcome.
Milagro, ¿tiene otra?
Yes.
Salió Gerson, ¿verdad? Que
sal... Allan.
Sí, en la cueva de donde tiene la
I'm staring in English by the end of the next year.
What do you say?
Repeat, please.
I'm mistaken.
¿Sí? Mastering. ¿Qué dominaré?
Ah, okay. Hi, guys. Okay. I think I got it. Maybe we can just change the pronunciation a little. We can say like mastering. I am going.
Mm-hmm. No.
I am mastering. Uh-huh, yeah. The rest is good. Mastering. I am mastering English by the end of the year. Yeah, that's good. I am mastering, or you can say I am speaking English well by the end of the year. But it's good, it's good.
I cleaning my computer quickly.
Hours. And you, Abilene?
I am having a meeting tomorrow at 6 a.m. I am looking the news tomorrow night. I am waiting a little for my bus. Mm-hmm. I am doing exercise tomorrow at 7 p.m.
Nice. I really like those activities. So you are doing exercise tomorrow before the class. Antes de la clase, at 7 p.m.
Uh-huh.
Really? Are you doing exercise tomorrow?
Cuando salgo temprano del trabajo, cuando me toca de día. Pero cuando estoy de noche, sí.
Really? Are you working at night? ¿Trabaja en la noche también?
Sí, hago turno de día y de noche. Wow. Cuando estoy de noche, entro a las 11 y salgo a las 7 de la noche.
Wow, okay. Sounds pretty tough. Okay. All right, girls. What about you? Are you doing exercise?
Manda?
I mean, what about the girls, the other girls? Are you doing exercise next week or this week? ¿Van a hacer ejercicio? Are you doing exercise?
¿En qué lugar, dice?
No, si las demás van a hacer ejercicio.
I don't. Someday I am dancing my...
Very nice. Are you dancing in your house?
Baila. Yes, in their house.
Ah, very nice. Dancing is super good. I love dancing. Okay. Sandra, yes. Are you doing exercise?
Now I don't know. Because I going work.
Okay. Sorry about that. Okay. I see that.
I am going work on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday.
Oh, but you have time on Tuesday and Thursday.
Yes. But Tuesday and Wednesday, and I sleep.
So you are sleeping. Okay, on your days off. Okay, now that's good. That's okay. Luz and you, what about you? Are you doing exercise this week?
I not. I have not exercise. I in the morning, in the afternoon, in the night. School activity, negocio.
You have a business.
Business.
Yes. Oh, you are a businesswoman. Okay. What do you sell?
Max TV Pro. TV, series, películas.
A salesperson. You are a salesperson.
Sí.
But you sell movies.
Yes, movies. It's company news.
Company news. Do you sell subscriptions?
Or
películas quemadas.
No, es la competencia, digámoslo así, por Netflix.
Subscriptions. So you sell subscriptions. Okay. So it's similar to Netflix.
Yes.
And the price?
Price, $5. In the month.
One account. Or two accounts? One account, una cuenta, or two, or three?
One
account, $5. Look, so Luz is a biznera. So she's a businesswoman. Very nice, Luz. Okay. Luz, le escribo después. We are going to make business. Okay, everybody, that was nice. Let's go back. Let's go to the other meeting. Thanks everybody for coming back. Let me see.
$5 es baratísimo.
But seriously, Luz, ya le escribo. When we finish the class, we are going to make business. Okay, everybody, so thank you so much for joining back. All right. Voy a pasar asistencia y de quienes me hacían falta. Give me just a quick second. Hold on. no ven mi pantalla, right? So I got, okay guys, solo me ayuden con present, please, when I say your name. So I have Christian.
Presente.
Yes, thank you, Christian. Isaac.
Present.
Oh, yes, I got it today, Isaac, thank you. Edith.
Present.
Thank you, Edith. Silvia. Creo que vi a Silvia hace unos segunditos.
Present.
Oh, there you are. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. And I have a, let me see, Cesar.
Present.
Thank you so much. Oh, almost, casi full house. Almost there, almost, almost. Let me just check. Ok, super nice everybody. Chicos, excelente attendance. I'm like checking here and super, super good job. Please, solamente asegurémonos que no faltemos más de, you know. Bueno, de hecho, no podemos faltar a ninguna, pero si es que like an emergency, una máxima, please. Just make sure that you got it. I'm checking here. Algunos tenemos full, 100 attendance. So, excelente trabajo a todos. Super nice job. Very good. Very good. Okay, guys. So, we were talking about your plans for the week. And tell me, ¿qué van a hacer? What are your plans for this week that is coming? What are you doing? So, I listened to a couple of you guys, but I didn't listen to some. So, Andres, tell me, what are you doing?
Hi, teacher.
Hey, Andres.
Tomorrow I am checking contract with my client.
Okay, okay. Thank you very much. And Christian, what are you doing tomorrow?
I'm going to work at 8 o'clock.
Okay, thank you very much. Edith, what are you doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow I'm going to the gym.
Okay, thank you very much. Very nice. Really? Is that in seriously?
No. Yes.
Okay, nice, nice. Madeline, what are you doing tomorrow?
I am cleaning my house tomorrow.
For real?
Yes.
Okay.
That's nice.
Or only the example. Okay, thank you. That's a really good one. Okay, guys, so let's continue. We were talking about some of these activities. Very nice job. And I have some exercises for you. So it says here, unscramble the following words to create sentences. Vamos a ponerlas en orden. We are going to organize these exercises, okay? And put them in order. So, ¿qué es lo que tenemos que recordar? Que sujeto, luego el verbo be, luego ing, y luego el complemento. Try to follow this and you will be fine. I will give you 5 minutes. Cuando termine, give me verbal confirmation, please. Thank you. Teacher. Thank you very much. Was it easy? Thank you, Harrison. Ay, ya lo veo. I see you now. Nice. So funcionó el troubleshooting. Nice. Thank you, Vero. Guys, estuvo fácil. Was it easy? Thank you, Francisco. Okay, everybody, so let's take a look at the possible answers, okay? So number one, la primera dice Jose is receiving the new workers tomorrow. And Luz tiene la número dos. Do you have number two?
Yes. Jane is, perdón. Mark is sending the letters the next week.
Yes, good, good, good. Excellent job. Number three. Let me see. I got Francisco, tiene la tres. Do you have number three?
Yes. Jane is working on the reports tonight.
Excellent job. Thank you. That's good. Fatima, number four. Do you have number four?
Walter is working on the road. No. Right. Walter is singing the shirt today.
Excellent, very good job. Guys, what is the meaning of signing? What is sign?
Firmar.
Firmar, excellent. So Walter is signing the checks today. Very good, thank you, Fatima. Number five, Doris, do you have number five?
Marina is organizing the presentation in the afternoon.
Thank you very much. Yes, so Marina is organizing and the rest is super good. Nice. Guillermo, number six, Guillermo, do you have Guillermo?
He is going to the bank tomorrow.
Very good. Guillermo is going to the bank tomorrow. Exactly. Very good, everybody. So if you check, you got it. Solamente vamos a respetar la estructura and you're super good with this. Okay. Nice. So I got like a little exercise for you guys. I know that the internet is not like super, super quick. Okay. But we are going to do a little exercise. So this is just called the, we are going to try to play charades. Okay. No sé si ya los han jugado. Pretty much is like this. Tenemos one sentence. Okay. Y usted tiene que hacer la mímica. You have to mimic the sentence para que los compañeros le adivinen what you're trying to. Quizás algunos el internet está como un poquito lento. Probably it doesn't work that much. But vamos a intentar hacerlo. We are going to try to do this. So, let me show you. Okay, give me 1 second. I need one volunteer, please. I just need one person. One volunteer. Christian.
Milagro, no he escuchado Milagro.
No, no hemos escuchado Milagro. Later, don't worry. Okay, so veo a Christian. I see Christian, he raised his hand. So Christian, le voy a mandar algo al chat. Give me just a second. Okay, everybody, so this is what we are going to be doing. Christian Alexander. Okay, so Christian, voy a mandarle una oración. I'm going to send him a sentence. Y él tiene que hacer la mímica. He has to mimic the sentence. So everybody, pay close attention to Christian and intenten adivinar qué es lo que él va a hacer mañana. So what is going, what is Christian going to do tomorrow? Oh, sorry, hold on.
Cerrar la puerta.
Okay, so Kristen, I sent it to you. So just please tell me, confirm if you got it. Yes. Okay, so you gotta mimic. Okay, use your body to mimic, and everybody pay attention to Kristen, please.
Pero no todos lo vemos.
I drive.
No, no todos vemos a Christian.
Driving. He is driving tomorrow.
Driving.
He is driving tomorrow.
Yes, very nice. Exactly. That was the sentence. I'm driving a car, but you say I'm driving tomorrow. That's good. Milagro, si ve la pantallita, de hecho no les comparto. Creo que ve a todos los compañeros, right?
Solo veo unos cuantos.
Muévalo con el dedo.
Hágalo más grande, hágalo más grande. Make it a little bit bigger. Ve la parte superior, dice vista. Usted la puede poner para ver a los 20 que estamos conectados ahorita. ¿Me confirma si logra verle?
No, no puedo.
Ah, ya sé cómo lo ve. Ok. So, en la parte de arriba, en la parte derecha, ve como un cuadrito que aparecen como si fuera un X0. En la parte superior derecha. Dele clic ahí. Le aparece como un cuadrito, como un menú.
Ahora sí.
Okay. ¿Nos ve a todos?
Sí, principalmente a Francisco.
Ah, ok, entonces todavía no. So, no, pero sí ve a todos. Can you see everybody?
Revisa el WhatsApp, please.
O ve a alguien más grande.
Ya ahorita ya pude, teacher.
Ah, ok, nice. Ok, so, Francisco, I was going to say, no, Christian, select one person.
El micrófono.
Where is
Gabriela.
Christian? Oh, Gabriela. Who is Gabriela?
Okay.
Oh, Madeline. That's Madeline. Okay. So, got it. And I was like,
yo sabía, yo es.
Yeah, that's personal. Okay. Okay. It's only like this is the last exercise. So Madeline, I'm going to send you the sentence. Okay. Please confirm if you got it. This is more difficult maybe. Okay. So everybody look at Madeline. Okay. And try to guess. Adivine. Try to guess what Madeline is doing. Maybe not her.
She.
Madeline is.
We.
Trying.
We are trying.
My sister is crying.
Francisco, what did you say?
My sister crying.
Oh, my sister?
He's crying.
Yes, very good. My sister is crying, exactly. Okay, everybody, so we are going to do this exercise just for like 3 or 4 minutes. Vámonos a los grupos. Let's go to the group super quick. Oh, I like this picture. Okay, so let's go to your groups. 4 minutes. Try to explain your classmates. Okay, remember, eso es un poquito de vocabulario combinado like with everything we have checked. So enjoy it. 5 minutes only y luego los traigo. Then I'll bring you back. So let's go, everybody. Let's go. Let's join the groups.
Charo, Charo.
Hi, no, go ahead, continue. I'm just a visitor here.
That's a question, teacher.
Yes.
¿Cómo hacer?
The same. So, de las oraciones que tienen, escojan una, mm-hmm. like choose one, and try to mimic it. But remember, get the full sentence, incluyendo el I am written, so the full thing. Mm-hmm.
Vaya, como yo ya participé, ahorita va Andrés.
Okay.
Pupusas tomorrow.
Okay.
Entonces le toca a Doris.
Doris.
Ay. Ahorita. No sé si me entiende hasta ahí.
No. Pero no vimos la seña.
Se le dio la mano.
¿Cómo?
No vimos la seña.
Ajá.
Ahí.
I am writing emails.
I am travel.
You are writing. Writing the emails.
Ah.
Oh, letters.
Yes, Caesar.
Letters. Okay, my turn. You're taking a picture. Yes. Yes, it's correct.
Se lo digo, yo voy mañana a comprar, les dije, a comprar una herramienta.
No,
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 lo puso difícil.
No, fácil.
Algo fácil.
La de Ada, como por ejemplo, ¿qué es lo que dijo Ada? Que mañana no va a comer watermelon.
That's difficult.
Next week.
Okay, girls, what about you?
Ahora usted, don Andrés, me va a preguntar algo.
What about you tomorrow, Luz?
No le vemos las manos.
Las manos.
Uh-huh. We cannot see your hands.
Voy a subir.
Okay.
Okay.
Writing.
Haciendo las pupusas, dije.
You made my day. I mean, not, yeah. Because you were moving fast. That was nice. That was fun, guys. Okay, guys, let's go back. Let's go back. Let's go to the other meeting. I'm still laughing at the pupusa thing. Okay, everybody. So, I'm missing some. Let's give them just some seconds. In just a minute.
Botones.
Okay, let me see. We are waiting for some of them. Okay, everybody. So thank you so much for coming back. 19. I'm missing one person. Okay. Okay, everybody. So thank you. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed it and you practiced a lot. Now, we were talking about activities that you have to do tomorrow. ¿Qué sucede si esto es algo que ustedes no van a hacer? All right. What if I ask you, hey, what are you doing tomorrow? Yeah. And you say, no, tomorrow no voy a llamar a mis papás. No puedo. Okay. No puedo en la mañana. So I am calling my parents in the morning. Para hacerlo negativo, ¿qué hacemos? This is super easy. I'm just going to include a not. So I am not calling my parents in the morning. So I'm not calling, I'm not going, I'm not reading, and you made this negative, okay? I am sending, so you can say, I'm not sending emails, okay? Like when you ask, for example, so are you talking to your friends? And you said, no, I'm not talking to my friends tomorrow, so no voy a hablar con ellos. I am cooking, hey guys, are you cooking dinner? Van a cocinar, van a hacer la cena. Are you cooking dinner? And you come and you say, no, si yo no cocino. Okay, so you say, I am not cooking dinner. Okay, so I'm not cooking dinner at night. I'm not cooking a breakfast. I'm not cooking at all right? So what are some activities that you are not doing? Algunas cosas que no vayan a hacer esta semana, right? So, for example, in my case, in todo el mes, this month, I am not, okay, this month, this is not like a plan, I am not going to the dentist. Going to the dentist. Todos los meses voy, but this month, I'm not going to the dentist, okay? So this month also, or this week, I am not. Es algo que no voy a hacer. Let me think, because this is difficult. I am not. For this week, for example, I'm not eating pupusas. So supposedly, I'm not
eating. Teacher, I have a question.
Yes, Milagro, tell me.
Cuando uno lo lee es yo no voy a ir al dentista, mm-hmm. o yo no iré al dentista.
Actually, es como algo que no está planeado. Entonces, en español lo leemos yo no voy a ir o yo no iré. So it's pretty much the same. It's similar. La diferencia en inglés es que esto sí es como cosas que no están planeadas, que no es un arrangement. No tiene cita, for example. So this is the point. En español nosotros lo leemos igual, right? No voy a ir, no iré. In English es un poquito diferente.
Okay, thank you.
I am not
iré
al cine.
I'm not going to the cinema. It's too dangerous now.
Dangerous, yes.
Yeah, it's very dangerous. Also, yeah, I'm not going to the supermarket. I'm not going to the cinema. ¿Qué más abrieron ya? What places are open?
Almacenes.
Mall.
Ajá, the mall, right? Mall. Yeah, I'm not going to any mall. I think it's too dangerous. Restaurants. Yeah, I'm not going to restaurants. De hecho, no he ido ni uno en todo el año. So I'm not going to a restaurant. I think it's too dangerous.
I am not going to a pupusódromo.
Olopita.
Yeah.
My family is from Olopita. I am going to the pupusódromo.
Yeah, no. Okay.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, definitely. Okay, so here we have
Do you make the pupusas, teacher?
Yes.
No, you
but
are
not so good.
Olopita people. What?
I am a disgrace to my family. No, I mean, they are not perfect, but my mothers are
super good. We approve.
So I am learning. Ah, you want some now, but it's too difficult. But I'm learning. I'm learning. I'm in the process. Se sale todo, but I'm in the process. Yeah. Okay, guys. So tell me, what are some of the things that you are not doing? ¿Qué es algo que no van a hacer? What is something you're not doing?
I am not working this Saturday.
Ah, very nice. Okay. Very good.
So I am not cutting my hair.
Really? Is it long? Is it long? ¿Está largo?
No.
No, but you're not cutting. Okay, you're not cutting your hair. Okay, thank you, Cesar. Any other example?
I am not running.
Oh, you're not running. Verónica, come on. Okay. Any other example?
I am not taking a shower at afternoon.
Ah, okay. I thought during the day. Okay, in the afternoon. Thank you, Andres. So, very nice. You got it. Yes.
Harrison? I am not going to the beach in the weekend.
Okay, you're not going to the beach.
I am now go to the English class tomorrow.
Harrison, what do you say? Can you repeat? I am calling you tomorrow if you don't come. No, okay, guys. Excellent, excellent. Very nice. I like it. You got it. Okay, super. Now, let's have a little, where is it? Now, with these, with the things that we have checked, okay, we are going to create, we are going to prepare a little conversation using present continuous. So, ¿qué pregunta podemos utilizar? What question can we use para generarla? We can use this one that is, what are you doing?
I can see your...
¿No puede ver mi pantalla? No.
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 Okay.
Mira si me encuentras el cargador ahí.
Entonces se me movió. Give me one second. Can you see my screen now? Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So we are going to prepare a conversation para hablar del futuro, to talk about the future, to talk about your plans, okay, for tomorrow, for Monday, for Tuesday, etc. So, la forma más fácil de generar la conversación is using this question. Like, hey, hello, Edith. Hello, Milagro. What are you doing tomorrow? Okay, so what are you doing, for example, next weekend? What are you doing on Saturday? So, este tomorrow puede cambiar. What are you doing on Monday? What are you doing next week? Okay, and you say, oh, I am playing. I am traveling with my family. Yes?
Teacher, a question.
Yes. Cesar, right?
In the last example, you say, what are do you tomorrow?
What are you doing tomorrow?
¿Cuál es la diferencia?
Wait. ¿Cómo era? Les di ese ejemplo.
Tú o das.
El ejemplo anterior, habíamos puesto una pregunta en donde poníamos, por ejemplo, I am cleaning my house. La pregunta era, what are do you tomorrow?
Vaya, permítame. Permítame, le comparto para que veamos. Creo que es esta, ¿verdad? Este de Word.
Yes.
Pero que es...
¿Aló?
I believe,
maybe,
Cesar. Yeah, me preocupó. I was like, no, what? What are you doing?
I-N-G.
Yes, yeah. So what are you doing tomorrow? Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Teacher, ¿verdad que aquí no se podría ocupar ni do ni das, verdad?
Correcto, no se puede. Uh-huh. We cannot use do or das. Porque tenemos el verbo be, and no lo puedo decir, what do you doing? Eso no se puede. So, what are you doing? What are you eating? What are you drinking? What are you cooking? So, lo único que vamos a hacer es
cambiar al final.
Exacto, este verbo lo cambiamos y puedo utilizar cualquiera que tenga ing. So, what are you cooking? What are you sending? What are you eating? What are you drinking? Pero la pregunta sí es, what are you doing? Lo que cambia tal vez sería este tomorrow por what are you doing next Monday, next Tuesday, next Wednesday, or what are you doing tomorrow night, para indicar que son planes al futuro. So, Cesar, ¿estamos bien, Cesar?
Yes, teacher, thanks.
Okay, okay, thank you. So, I was worried. No, yeah, maybe, you know, maybe I made a mistake. Okay, so everybody, vamos a irnos a los grupos. Los voy a mover para que trabajen con alguien más. And we are going to create a short conversation, okay? And then we come and we present it. So you have 10 minutes to prepare this conversation. And everybody, let's go and let's join the groups. Enjoy it.
Teacher, la pregunta es, ¿qué harás mañana?
Uh-huh.
¿Qué y la palabrita esta, doing,
¿Es doing? Acá?
Sí, esa es la que quiere decir, ¿qué harás? ¿Qué vas a hacer?
Sí, Miss, en realidad este are no significa mayor cosa, lo que me indica la acción es esto. Y por eso, ajá, es que yo este lo puedo cambiar, y puedo decir, what are you eating? ¿Qué vas o qué irás a comer? ¿Qué vas a comer? Uh-huh. Y por eso es que usamos doing, ¿qué vas a hacer? Pero yo puedo cambiar esta, por ejemplo, ¿qué vas a cocinar? What are you cooking? O cualquier acción que vaya casada con what. ¿Qué vas a tomar? What are you drinking? Recordemos que el you puede ser que vas, como salvadoreño decimos de vos, right? Voceamos. Pero puede ser como ¿qué va a tomar? O ¿qué vas a tomar? So, what are you drinking tomorrow? Yes?
Y puede ser, what are you eating in the lunch, on the lunch?
What are you eating?
In the lunch?
¿Qué vas a comer de almuerzo?
Yes, yes, uh-huh, of course. What are you eating for lunch tomorrow? Of course. Uh-huh. Yes. Amigos, se puede formular muchísimas más. Esa es como solamente la base para crear más. Sería siempre recomendable utilizar este for breakfast, uh-huh, for lunch, for dinner. Lo demás, very nice. Okay. Yes. Uh-huh. Okay, everybody. So let's join the groups. You're welcome. Let's practice. And you have only like 8-9 minutes, and I'll see you in a bit. So let's go, guys.
Yo no tengo el enlace para entrar al grupo.
Oh, ¿no le parece?
No.
Permítame ahorita, voy ahorita a la...
Okay, thank you.
Ahora sí, bye. Okay. Hi. Hi, Bori.
La tabla, la de oraciones, no le aparece ahí.
Espérame, que ahorita estoy intentando abrir una... Ahí estoy, ya. Uy, sí. a saber que le toqué y se me quedó la pantalla ahí en blanco. Pero
no,
ya.
Pero yo creo que es el sistema porque
es que
a mí me sacó.
Me abruma la tecnología.
The 66 years old. Yes?
No, dale.
We celebrate, como decir, sus 66 años.
66 years old. Sus, ajá, sí.
Ajá.
We celebrate, no, it's his, her 60, 66, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Years
old. Her 66 years old. Old. Years
66, dice.
Sí.
And what about you, Harrison? What are you doing tomorrow?
Well, I am going to the work and I go to the bank and make a balance sheet in my work, and I am having a meeting in the afternoon with my boss.
I'm going to work.
I am going to my work tomorrow, and I am going to the bank, and I am, bueno, lo voy a cortar. I am having a meeting with my boss. It's a hard day tomorrow.
I am having,
yes.
I am having meeting my boss.
I am having a meeting with my boss. My boss. You lose.
He can help you.
Porque él puede ayudarte
to organize the meeting in all the activities.
Listo.
Ah, pues que diga algo Isaac ya, como que ella lo llamó, ¿o no?
Habría que, o sea, como Doris dice, va, yo le voy a llamar, ella le tendría que llamar y él le tendría que responder.
Ah, va, entonces ahí termina y usted empieza a hablar por teléfono y dice, hi Isaac.
Y ahí ya empieza la conversación entre Doris y Isaac.
Can you come to the restaurant? Algo así, no sé.
Hey, Isaac, can you come, sería, ¿verdad?
Ah, nice.
A veces.
Sometimes.
Casi nunca.
So never.
Only Sunday for Monday.
Ah, nice.
A lot of much working.
Okay.
Avilén.
Yes.
What are you doing at Thursday afternoon?
Tuesday. I am having received English class.
At noon.
Ah, la tarde.
At noon.
Ah, studying in homework English.
Yes, nice. She used to study in English. You see, very responsible. An extra point for her.
Studying applique.
Ahora yo pregunto.
Ahorita voy a copiar primero lo que me pregunta, ¿sí?
No.
Repeat, please.
What are you doing in your house?
Are you doing
next Friday?
In your house. In your house?
In the next Friday.
Next Friday.
¿Cómo contesto, pues?
I'm not.
Para decir, yo no tengo nada que hacer el viernes por la tarde.
I am not.
El próximo viernes. I am not.
Yeah, exactly. Hagámoslo con continuous. I am not.
Going.
Pero ¿cómo es hacer? I am not.
I am not have.
Agréguemele, no, porque have es tener y quiero hacer having. Hacer. Pero hacer es...
I am not having. No, vea.
El otro, hacer.
Hacer.
Yeah.
Doing.
Doing. I am not doing.
I am not doing
anything. I'm not doing anything.
Anything.
I'm not doing anything next Saturday. So no voy a hacer nada. I'm not doing anything.
Anything.
Mm-hmm.
I am not doing anything.
Yes, I'm not doing anything.
Mm-hmm. I am not doing anything. Guillermo, what yes. are you doing in... No. What are you doing the next next year's old, ¿verdad? Si quiero preguntar qué harás el próximo año.
No, only next year is good.
Next year, ¿no?
What are you doing next year? Yes, porque si me le dice all, es esa edad. So, all puede ser más específica. What are you doing in 2021, en el 2021? Uh-huh. So, what are you doing next year? What are your plans for next year? That's okay.
Next year. Guillermo, what are you doing next year?
I'm not going to try get my goals because I'm
The most difficult part, Silvia.
Okay, everyone. So thank you very much for coming back. We are going to move to the conversation part, to the presentation one. So volunteers, do I have any volunteer? Everybody will participate, but who would like to be first? Where is Milagro? No, just kidding. She is always first. She always volunteers. So first, Sandra Patricia, I'm going to choose you first today. Are you ready? Your group ready? So let me take a look. Sandra was with...
Sorry. Estamos en Fátima.
Francisco and Fátima.
Ah, okay. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Okay. Please help us a little bit with your presentation.
Un momentito.
Hola, hola, hola.
Ready?
Ya.
How are you, Fatima?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
I'm great. Tell me, what are you doing next weekend?
I am cooking my breakfast. I am going shopping in the supermarket. I am visiting my family in San Miguel. What are you doing next week, Sandra? I am going my father in San Vicente in the morning and eating in the beach in company with my husband and Sunday after, and Sunday. Tell me, Edith, what are you doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow in my work, I am check my emails and in the afternoon, I'm meeting, I have a meeting with my boss at 2 o'clock. And in the afternoon, I go to the park with my son for the playing. Only in Francisco.
I am making my homework. I am going to visit my mother. And I go to beach for eat fish. That's it.
Nice. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. That was very good. Guys, emojis. That was nice. Yes, Francisco?
Teníamos una duda.
Yes.
Puedo ocupar dos verbos. Uno está en...
For example?
Como por ejemplo esa que dice, I am going to the beach for eat fish.
For eating.
Eating.
Yes, eating or to eat. No, if you say for, I am going to the beach for eating, or I'm going to the beach to eat.
Ah, to eat.
To eat. Mm-hmm. Very nice, guys. I really like your conversation. You included a lot of vocabulary and your plans. Oh, your baby is so cute. Okay, thank you, guys. So next one, Francisco, select next. Francisco, who is next?
Oh.
Perdón. Gerson.
Okay. So he knew it.
Thank you, Francis.
Gerson, go. Let's go.
Okay. My group is Christian. No, not Sam.
Luz.
Silvia. Okay. I saw. Hello, Christian. What are you doing this weekend?
Hi, Harrison. I'm fine. And thanks for asking. On this weekend, I'm going to the beach with my mother, with my family, because it's my mother's birthday. We celebrate her 66 years old. What about you, Harrison? What are you doing tomorrow?
I am going to the I am going to my work, and next in the morning I am going to the bank. In the afternoon I am having a meeting with my boss. Christian, are you inviting to Luz at your mother's birthday?
Maybe I do it, but what do you think, Luz?
Hi, Christian. I'm sorry. Luz, I'm going to supermarket at 3 p.m. and cleaning my house at 10 a.m. Hello, Silvia. You can accompany Christian mother birthday?
Oh, sorry, Luz. I don't going because I am working all week. And the weekend, I visit my family.
It's all, teacher. That's it.
Oh, okay, thank you, guys. So in the end, sorry, Christian, nobody else is going to your birthday, to your mother's birthday. Thank you, guys. That was a very good one. Guys, share your emojis with the group. So thank you. Thank you for sharing them. Good. On the Christian, select next person, please. Or next group.
Doris.
Doris, where is Doris? So in Doris group, I can see here we have Isaac, Madeline, and Sandra.
Yes.
Okay, guys.
Ya sabía yo que no me podía salvar de Christian.
Bueno. No, pero no sabía.
Sabía ahora.
Hi, Sandra. Nice to see you.
Hello, Madeline. She is my friend Doris.
Hi, Madeline. Nice to meet you.
I am very busy because I am organizing a meeting tomorrow.
I'm calling to Isaac because he can help you to organize the meeting and all the activities. Hi, Isaac. Can you come as Pollo Real in this moment? Isaac?
Yes, of course.
Yes, it's food.
Come here, please. And I am saying all the time.
Okay, right now I arrive.
That's it, teacher. No terminamos la conversación.
No, that was good. That was really nice. Thank you.
Tomorrow continue.
Yeah, to be continued like the movies. No, that was very nice, guys. Thank you very much. Give me just a second because I think I'm missing some groups. So Doris group is good. I haven't heard Ava, Andres, Avilene, and Cesar. So guys, let's go for it.
Hello, Avilene.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Avilene. How are you?
Hello, Andres. I'm fine. I'm fine.
Fine, and you?
Fine, thank you.
Fine.
What are you doing tomorrow, Andres?
Hi, Cesar.
Hi, Cesar.
Hi, Cesar.
Hey. I am going to barbershop, then I am paying some bills in the bank, and in the afternoon I watching TV series.
Oh,
Thank you.
And you, Ada, what are you doing tomorrow?
I am wake up in the morning at the, at the 5 o'clock. I am going to the work in the hospital at the 7, 8 o'clock. I am at the meeting in, I have the meeting in tomorrow at 10 at the morning. I have the, I have the check the patient then tomorrow at the 10, no, 2 and 4 p.m. What are you doing tomorrow, Avilent?
I am doing exercise at 3 p.m. and I am doing draw. I don't have check reports for my work. Finish.
And you, Andres, what are you doing tomorrow?
I am cooking my dinner tomorrow and all weekend.
Okay, and every day.
Every day.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Very nice. Very good explanation of your plans. It is about time, pero les voy a robar solo un minutito for the last presentation, that is Guillermo, Milagro, and Vero. So I want everybody also to listen to you. So everybody, let's go. One more minute.
Hurry up, Milagros.
I don't see Milagro. Where is she? Oh, there she is. Okay, guys, are you ready? Berito, Milagro, Guillermo.
Creo que nosotros comprendimos mal las indicaciones.
Ajá,
estuvimos practicando las oraciones. Ajá.
Nosotros nos hicimos las preguntas. Por ejemplo, yo le preguntaba a Guillermo. Guillermo, hello, Guillermo. What are you doing next week?
But that's okay. That's fine. So.
Él contestaba.
No, but I mean, esa es la idea de la conversación, right? Hacerlo mm-hmm. más natural. So yes, yes, of course, you can ask that.
Mm-hmm. ¿Quién me contesta?
So ask them directly, like Guillermo, Milagro.
Mm-hmm. And the next week, I'm going to working to my work because my car is going to workshop.
Mm-hmm. Milagro. Milagro.
Hola.
Yes, she's
Hi,
there.
Milagro. Uh-huh. Hi, Milagro. What are you doing next Monday?
Ya tengo sueño.
Yes, I know. We finished with you guys.
¿Qué me preguntó, Vero?
Hi. What are you doing next Monday?
I am not doing anything.
Okay.
Practico.
But we got it.
Practico, rápido, nice. Y ya nos vamos. Mm-hmm.
Precise and concise. No, that was good. Okay, everybody, thank you. I like that expression, I'm not doing anything. So we will practice this tomorrow. Thank you, everybody, for your attendance. Please, no se les olvide contestar la tarea número 11. Have a good night and bye-bye. See you tomorrow.
Good night, everybody. Bye. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
tomorrow.
Right.